Ladies and gentlemen, welcome back. This is EKB, EKB TV, and you are watching The Vintage Cigar, and we're back with another review. And today we are reviewing the Sobra Mesa Brulé Blue. Now, for you guys who have been following this channel for a long time, you know this has been a long time coming. This is actually a cigar that I've been waiting to smoke for quite some time. I smoked the Sobra Mesa, but I've never got a chance to have the Brulé Blue. And when I did the review, I went back on this particular cigar and I had some thoughts on it. You know, if you guys went back through the show, you saw how I actually felt about this cigar. Let's take a look. Told you Steve Saka is going to make it up to you. The Sobra Mesa Brulé Blue. What's interesting about this is that I actually tried to hunt this cigar down. I went on a website, typed in my information, got myself on a waiting list, but I live in Japan. So when everyone else is wide awake in the United States, I'm sleeping. So I got the notice while I was sleeping that the Brulé Blue had come back out and it's been re-released. By the time that I woke up, saw the message, sold out.
Oh my God!
One day, Steve Saka, one day. We've come a long way, right? So it's a welcome change. Glad we were able to kind of step the show up a little bit. Let's take a look at this cigar. This cigar is absolutely beautiful. It's one of my favorite looking cigars out there. I love a good Corona. This is a Grand Corona. This is 6.25 by 48, if I'm correct. I'll double check myself up here and I'll update it on the screen and let you guys know if I don't have it exactly right. I love the shape of the cigar. I love the way it feels in the hand. And just this is absolutely one of my favorite Patolas. But aside from that, this cigar has a Ecuadorian Connecticut wrapper on top. The binder is Mexican, is Metacapan, if I have that correct, and it's Nicaraguan fillers. Exact same as the larger size that I smoked previously on another show, but this is a different Patola, so I wanted this experience. I absolutely love the band on this cigar. I love the way the cigar looks. I think Steve Saka went out of his way to make just one of the most beautiful looking cigars that's out there when it came to this. Just the presentation is spectacular. It drew me in. It made me want to smoke this cigar. Now, more importantly, smoking this cigar was a fantastic experience from the start. Right away, the draw on this thing was fantastic. It had a really good burn, and the flavor profile for this blend is not what you would expect. Initially, this is like a bold and strong Cuban. You get cedar, you get pepper, you get hay, and there is just spicy strength, almost like a bitterness that goes with the cigar. And it's bitter in a good way. Sometimes, I think in Japan, they call that nekai, if I have that correct. There's a brown butter level that goes in there. It kind of coats your tongue because it's a level of oiliness in there, but it also gives you that savory, bittery note that goes along. And it stays for the first portion of the cigar. And, you know, you want that bitter sensation. You want that bitter taste. This is not a Connecticut that you would expect. It's not gonna be a faint Connecticut. It's not gonna be soft and bland and what you're not getting that with the cigar. Expect complexity. Moving into the second third, this is where the cigar starts to evolve and it starts to come alive a little bit more. I still had an interesting burn on this cigar. It wasn't as nice and pristine as the Sobra Mesa that I had before. The ash drops kind of quickly, but you know, when it holds on, it is a beautiful looking ash. It's kind of a wavy-ish burn, but it's still a nice burn to the cigar. But flavor-wise, this is when this thing comes alive. It starts to evolve, and it starts to give you the depth that you were looking for. The cedar remains. The spices for the red pepper, the black pepper, those notes still stay there. But it kind of evolves, and it grows into this creamier, nuttier flavor profile. And it's so much better, and it gives you like a depth, but it still gives you something to chew on, you know, literally while you're smoking the cigar. Like, there's a creamy, chewy texture to the smoke. It's a beautiful smoke output, but this is definitely medium. This is a stronger cigar. It starts to evolve a bit more, and you get this kind of cereal type note that goes along with there. And there's a sweetness, kind of a vanilla, and a another sweetness that, you know, lasts on the finish that comes in the background. And honestly, I can't describe what that sweetness is, but it starts to peak to go with those spicy, you know, earthier, woodier notes that goes along with the cigar. This is not a breakfast cigar. This is a definitely a stronger cigar that is made for kicking back, having a good drink, having a good meal, or if you really want to savor these flavors. So we're moving into the final portion of the cigar. And the finish on this gives you a deeper, richer, darker, chocolatier, and coffee note. And the peanut stays in there, and it's a nice blend. Honestly, when I got to the final third, I was still into the cigar, man, and I was enjoying it. The strength of the cigar always catches me off guard. And I never expected, you look at this cigar, it's a breakfast Connecticut, but it does not smoke that way. I actually really, really dig this cigar. I had to get a review out for this. I'm glad I got a chance to actually smoke it, especially in this Fatola. It's one that I hope to have around and keep around in the humidor. I think you guys will enjoy it. If you're looking for a Connecticut that actually has some complexity, that has some depth to it, that gives you some spikes and some changes and transitions in the flavor notes, this is the way to go. But make sure you have something around. It's a sober mesa. You have something to eat, something to keep you satiated and satisfied, because this is not going to be a lightweight Connecticut. It looks that way, but it's not. Keep that in mind. Hope you guys enjoy. This is EKB, EKB TV. You guys keep watching. We got more reviews right here. It's going to be more from Steve Saka in the box that I got. And I got some really cool cigars coming up. Thanks for the follows. Keep pressing like. Keep subscribing. Keep sharing this with your friends. Stay tuned. Be cool. Keep smoking.